What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another. So, according to recent reports, undefeated, unified, WBA, WBC, IBF, welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, Earl the True Spence Jr., who is widely considered top two, if not number one, definitely top five, pound for pound, best fighters in the world. With a record of 28 wins, no losses, no draw, 22 big wins by way of knockout, 32 years of age, 5'9", with a 72-inch arm reach. He will be taking on former unified WBC, WBA welterweight world champion, superstar boxer Keith Wontown Thurman. Keith Thurman is 30 wins, 1 loss, no draws, 22 wins by way of knockout. Keith Thurman is 34 years of age, 5'8", with a 69-inch arm reach. With that said, according to these reports, Earl Spence and Keith Thurman will be fighting at 154. Okay, Earl Spence is going to be making his debut at 154. Okay, this is a one-off, according to the WBA World Boxing Association president Gilberto Mendoza. They want to give Earl Spence a one-fight pardon, actually a two-fight pardon. Giving Errol Spence the ability to go fight Keith Thurman at 154, then he can come back down. And the only exception is he has to make the fight, the biggest fight in boxing with his biggest rival, an undefeated three-division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, currently the reigning WBO welterweight world champion, most widely considered by many to be the number one best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Boyd Crawford. Terrence Crawford has a record of 30 wins by way of knockout. He is 35 years of age, 5'8", with a 74-inch arm reach. So they're giving Errol Spence the pardon to fight Terrence Crawford. If he does not, he will be stripped of his belt. So this is a pardon. They're giving him a one fight off to allow him to keep the belt and still be able to fight against Terrence Crawford. With that said, the WBC is also giving him a pardon because Keith Thurman is his mandatory, but he's his mandatory at 147. But they're going to allow this to be a mandatory fight at 154. Okay, now the only hinge, as I told you guys, that was stopping this fight from happening was the International Boxing Federation president, Mr. Peoples, who is ordering 120 days for his next fight, which would be Earl Keith Thurman. After 120 days after that Keith Thurman fight, he's going to have to satisfy his mandatory challenge in Jerome Boutin, his welterweight superstar title contender, before this past weekend. Now, what's interesting to me is this. They're reporting that this fight is going to take place in April, okay? So they're saying that Errol Spence, Keith Thurman fight will take place in April. The one thing that gives me cause for pause is that April 15th is supposed to be the date for a mega pay-per-view fight between Javante Tank Davis, who just fought this weekend, undefeated three-division world champion, superstar boxer, who is pound for pound, rising on that list, pay-per-view cash cow, and quickly becoming the face of the sport of boxing. And with that said, he's supposed to face off against undefeated lightweight junior welterweight wrestler superstar title contender King Ryan Garcia April 15th in a mega pay-per-view event. That would be April 15th. So they're reporting that Errol Spence and Keith Thurman is going to be a pay-per-view fight as well. I don't see how Errol Spence and Keith Thurman is going to be pay-per-view in April on Showtime. At the same time, Ryan Garcia and Javante Davis going to be a pay-per-view event on Showtime. That gives me cause to wonder if this is actually going to take place in April. And another thing I don't like about this is Errol Spence has already expressed that, it's not easy for him to make 147 pounds. So for Errol Spence to go up to 154 and then attempt to make his way back down to 147, same on his body to attempt to come back down from 154 to 147. And the other thing is he going to be fully at his full strength to face off against Terrence Crawford? Okay. Because are we going to get the best version of Errol Spence to attempt to come back down from 154 to 147 to make that, once his body get acclimated to 154, that's a very risky, dangerous attempt to try to come back to 47 if you already stated that he's struggling to make 47, unless Errol Spence has plans to fight Terrence Crawford at some sort of catchweight. Errol Spence, I guess this is a way to, satisfy Errol Spence not really wanting to face off against Keith Thurman. Never really wanted to since 2017, 2018, when he was pursuing a fight with Keith Thurman when they were both champions, and Errol Spence won his first belt May of 2017. Keith Thurman unified the belts March of 2017 against two-division world champion Puerto Rican superstar boxer Danny Swift Garcia. So, with that said, it's just very, very risky in my opinion to see Errol Spence go to 154. And I have my doubts that it happens in April on a pay-per-view event because Javante Tate Davis, Ryan Garcia, already has a date of April 15th. Okay? So, that gives me pause for cause. And again, another thing I don't like about it is that the 154, going to 154 and then attempting to come back down to 147, I don't like that risk. I think Errol Spence, I would like the better if they fought in catchweight like 150, something like that. I think Errol Spence is going to stop Keith Thurman to the body. What he does great is Keith Thurman's biggest weakness. Keith Thurman is weak to the body, and Errol Spence is a body snatcher. So, when you look at it from that standpoint, I just think that, it's a big fight, and I think Errol Spence is going to stop Keith Thurman. I just can't see it happening in April. Or one of these fights is not happening. Javante Tate Davis is not happening. Errol Spence, Keith Thurman, one of them is not going to happen. They're not going to have two major pay-per-view events in 1 month. That's not going to happen. So, let's see how this unfolds and plays out. But that's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button, drop a comment in the comment section, let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't subscribed.